A very good morning to all of you. Hope you are fit and healthy. Before starting with the next chapter, I would like to ask you a few questions. What type of government do we have? Yes, democratic government. So what is democracy? Okay, power to the people to vote. That means democratic government is a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. In a democracy, people expect the government to work for their welfare. And this could be done through the provision of education, health, employment, housing, or the development of roads, electricity, etc. All these facilities could be enjoyed only if we are healthy. So children, today we will examine the meaning and problems related to health. We are going to start with chapter 2, civics, role of the government in health. Today we are going to cover two topics, what is health and health care in India. Health is an important issue for everyone. So children, what does health mean? Does it mean our capacity to remain free from illness or injuries, or you can say to be disease free? But health isn't only about disease. Agar aapko koi bimari nahi hai, iska matlab aap swasth hai, aisa nahi hai. Apart from disease, several other factors are also there that contribute to the good health. For example, agar saaf peene ka paani ho aur pollution free environment ho, to we are likely to be healthy. If we get adequate food, hygienic conditions and a sound state of mind, that is without mental strain, then we are healthy. So children, health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely the absence of disease. Coming on to the next topic, health care in India. Open to page 20 of your books, you can see there are two columns. After reading these two columns, you have to provide a title to these columns. Here we will examine some of the aspects of health care in India. We are going to compare and contrast the situation expressed in the first and the second column. If we look at the first column, there are some facts that will give you an idea about the present state of healthcare services in our country. Whereas, when you look at the second column, these facts regarding the state of healthcare in our country, which will give you a completely different picture. There is no doubt that we have a large number of doctors, clinics and hospitals, money, knowledge and an experienced pool of professionals who can run various healthcare systems. But in spite of all these, we are unable to provide necessary healthcare facilities to all people. In this chapter, we will look at some of the reasons for this. I am going to tell you the story of Hakim Sheikh. He was a member of Paschim Banga Khet Mazdoor Samiti, an organization of agricultural laborers in West Bengal. He accidentally fell off a running train and suffered head injuries and was in a very serious condition. He needed immediate treatment. He was taken to a government hospital, but they refused to admit him because they did not have spare beds. Some hospitals refused because they did not have facility or specialized doctors. He spent 14 hours in critical state and finally he was admitted in a private hospital where he received treatment. He spent a lot of money on his treatment. Because of this, angry and upset Hakim Sheikh filed a case in the court. So children, read the story again and imagine that if you are a judge in the court, what would you say to Hakim Sheikh? Thank you and have a nice day.